スペインのカタルーニャ州
政府観光局、
主催のですね
イベントがあるということで、
はい、
ご招待いただいて、
はい
はい、
楽しみですね。
サンジョルディの日ということで、はい、いろいろ探求していきたいと思います、
はい、中も、
はい、
いろいろ
ご紹介できるかな、
はいはい、
では後ほど。
I'm working for the Catalunya Shuseifu Kanko Kyoku. So we are the regional government of Catalunya. Mm-hmm. My name is Raul Guerra.
Raul-san.
Yes, and we promote Catalunya as a destination among the Japanese market.
Yes.
Now it's 3 years for
three
me.
3 years for me. So you know Japan very well.
I still many things to learn and to discover about Japan, but yeah, let's say I know a little bit about Japan.
I see, yes.
The capital city for Catalunya is Barcelona. Mm-hmm. You know, there are many difference in many different places in Catalonia to be discovered for the Japanese market. And one of these places, the one we were talking before, is about Costa Brava. It's the northeast of Catalonia, you know, and has famous places like the village where Salvador Dalí was born. Or many famous restaurants like El Bulli,
yes.
Or many other, or for example, also Celler de Can Roca is another 3-star Michelin restaurant.
Yes.
Yeah, let's say that all this Costa Brava, that's, I shouldn't say this, but that's, from my point of view, is the most beautiful seaside from, from I would say, yeah, all the Mediterranean.
Also, you are from this region?
Yeah, I am from Girona, which is in the area of Costa Brava.
I see.
Yes. So, I would say why Japanese would like to visit Catalonia. There are three elements. One is gastronomy, yes. Food. Another one is art and culture.
Yes.
And another one is natural sceneries, you know, the landscape. I think these are the three key elements that makes Catalunya different and special compared to other destinations. I would say, you know, every depending on the season that you travel, you will have different attractions. But for example, something that is still very unknown and could be very attractive, the city of Girona, you know, where I come from, in May, actually around Golden Week period, we have this flower festival. The whole city, the whole city center is covered by flowers, you know, and even the private gardens, they open the doors for visitors. So you can see the city. It's not only that you see the beauty of the city with flowers, is that you can discover the hidden places that not even locals we know, because of private gardens. They allow you to go and visit these private gardens in private houses. So this is one of the attractions that you could find only in May, during 1 week in May.
Just one week.
But of course, I think some other events related to gastronomy, for example, calzutada, is the, you know, during the months, or is for winter early, yeah, it's for winter, February and March. Mm-hmm. We have this spring onion, this not a spring onion, these long onions that we eat about this calzutada. This is something very typical, but only happens during February and March every year. So, and of course, another element that could be very attractive for the artistic and cultural value will be, we have this similar to Matsuri in Japan. We have a local festivities in all the villages, normally during the summertime. So visiting any of these local festivals, I think it's something that can be very unique experience for visitors. Today is one of the most special. Today is San Jordi. San Jordi is the day of the books and the roses, but also is the day for the lovers. It's like the Catalan San Valentine's Day. So normally we give roses and books with the people that we love and we appreciate. So it's very typical that the day of San Jordi, people come back at home with a lot of books that friends and people that loves you has given to you, and especially women with many roses that men give to them. So this is our San Valentine's Day. And actually, I have to say that in Catalonia, San Valentine's Day is not that popular because we have our own. And this day is also the International Day of the Book. It's the day that Cervantes and Shakespeare were born. So for many reasons, but was selected by the international as an International Day of the Book. So that makes this day very special for us.
Okay.
Konnichiwa.
今日はですね、トラベリングゴージャススペシャルバージョンということで、顔出しは初めてですね。
そうですね。
いつもはですね、ミスター北条と私のダラダラトークをですね、カメラの向こう側で、お手伝いしてくださっているミス中子さんですが、今後はですね、頻繁に登場していただく予定でおります。トラベリングゴージャス世代、ドンピシャでいらっしゃいますから、チームのですね、もう有能なセクレタリーでありますので、忌憚なき意見をどんどん言ってもらえればいいかなと思います。まあミスター北条はご存知の通り、旅行業界現役の業界の中の人で、ミス中子さんは
ど素人って
旅行業界的にはということですけれども、はい、いわゆるだからユーザー側ですよね。
そうですね。
旅行会社とか旅行代理店で、私はユーザーではあるんですけれども、ミスター北条と組んでプランニングですとかツアーのプロデュースもしている関係上、ちょうどその真ん中的な立場でお届けしたいと思います。
よろしくお願いいたします。
私とミスター北条の付き合いは、もう10年近くになるんですけれども、何気に中子さんもそのぐらいになりますよね。
あ、そうですかね。
ね、北条さんのこと知らないですよね、私たち。
知らないですね。私は全然存じ上げないですね性別男性ということぐらい
私も同じような感じなんですけれども、まあ、旅行会社のお偉いさんで50代後半、人当たりソフトで、常識的なというか、そんなにとんがった人でもなくて、
そうですね、物腰
柔らかな、本当に、ね、老若男女に好かれるタイプの方なんですけれども、意外と秘密主義で、
あ、そうなんですか。
もうプライベートについては多くを語らずどころか、ほぼ語らず、会社の人は知ってるのかな、
謎に包まれた
今度はそうですね、部下のアシスタントの女性とか捕まえて聞いてみようかなと思いますけど、自転車に乗っていることは一つ確か。
自転車、
通勤とか会社からどっかに営業に行く時とかも乗ってるみたいです。246あたりを意外と走ってるみたいですよ
これで北条さんに対して興味をお持ちになっていただければ、前の動画を見ていただいて、
そうですね、
興味が湧いてきたという方いらっしゃれば、 ご連絡を
よろしくお待ちしてます。